There are four types of symmetries in a crystal: translational, rotational, reflection, and inversion symmetry. These four symmetries together form a unit cell of a crystal. In this video of crystal structure, we will learn about the four symmetries found in crystal. Let's first talk about translational symmetry. In crystals, the arrangement of atoms is not in a random way, but in a well-defined order, in such a way that repetition of atoms form a crystal structure. This repetition of atoms is called periodicity. Periodicity means that the atom or atomic structure will repeat itself after every distance. This is an 1D monoatomic lattice, having atoms of mass m. Since all atoms are the same and repeating themselves after every distance a, so the periodicity of this lattice will be a. Such repetition of atom or atomic structure is called translational symmetry. Translational symmetry defines the repetition of another atom in the form of a vector in respect to one atom, which is called translational vector. As the atom q is on 2a distance with respect to atom p, the translational vector between them will be 2a. Similarly, atom R is at 3a distance with respect to atom P, then the translational vector between them will be 3a. This is a two-dimensional crystal structure, wherein the periodicity between atoms is a in x direction and b in y direction. Talking about translational symmetry between atom P and Q, atom Q is at a distance in the x direction and at 2b distance in y direction from atom P. The translational vector for these will be a plus 2b. Similarly, the translational vector between atom P and R will be 3a plus 2b. Talking of 3D lattice, due to the arrangement of atoms in three directions x, y, and z, a third term will add to the translational vector. In general, the translational vector for a lattice point is defined by this equation, where a, b, and c are primitive translational vectors of lattice and n, l, m are integers. Translational symmetry is the shift of a specific pattern to a specific direction, ensuring that there is no rotation or reflection in the pattern during this shift. During translational symmetry, the distance, angle, size, and shape between the two points of the pattern is constant. Only the location of points will be changed. The pattern can shift in any direction. In short, if there is a point shift in translational symmetry, its surrounding will be exactly the same as it was before. Next symmetry is rotational symmetry. If a crystal rotates itself with respect of its center of axis, the crystal repeats itself in a complete rotation of 360 degrees. This is called rotational symmetry of the crystal, such as triangle. After rotating a triangle 360 degrees on its center of axis, it repeats its structure after every 120 degrees. This is called rotational symmetry of the triangle. The number of times a crystal repeats itself in 360 degrees is called the fold of rotation or multiplicity of rotation of that crystal. Like, the fold of rotation of a triangle is 3 because it repeats itself 3 times in 360 degree rotation. Talking about a few more fold of rotations, an arbitrary shape repeats itself once in 360 degree rotation. Hence, it has one fold rotational symmetry. Similarly, two fold rotation in a rectangle, three fold rotation in a triangle, four fold rotation in a square, and six fold rotational symmetry in a hexagon are found. 5-fold or 7-8 or higher fold rotational symmetry does not exist. This is because of the translational symmetry found in the crystal. According to this symmetry, repetition of unit cell in a crystal should be such that there is no vacant space between them. Translational vectors can be defined only for such crystals. Talk about 5-fold rotation, then the unit cell will be pentagon for this. But when pentagons form the crystal by arranging the unit cells side by side, then there are vacant space between the unit cells. Because of this, translational vectors cannot be defined for such crystals. This is the reason why 5-fold rotational symmetry does not exist. This is also the reason why higher fold rotational symmetries does not exist. Next symmetry is reflection symmetry. If it is possible to draw a line through a two-dimensional lattice or a plane through a three-dimensional lattice, which divide the lattice into two halves in such a way that both halves are mirror images of each other, then it is called reflection symmetry. It is denoted by M. If a line is drawn through lattice, causing the lattice to divide into two mirror images, then it is represented by single M. And if it is possible to draw two lines, then it is represented by double M. Sometimes in a lattice, rotation and reflection symmetries may be possible together. Such a combination is called rotoreflection symmetry. In this way, rotational symmetry may be possible in two different ways. One, rotation without reflection, and the another, rotation with reflection. Their possible combinations can be 10, 5 out of which are without reflection, also called pure rotation, and 5 with reflection, which is called rotoreflection. The fourth crystal symmetry is inversion symmetry. Inversion symmetry is also similar to reflection symmetry. The only difference is that reflection in reflection symmetry is through a plane, whereas the reflection in inversion symmetry is through a point called inversion center or center of symmetry. It means to say that a point in lattice is such that through lattice point invert and found on the other side of the point is called inversion symmetry. This symmetry is found only in three-dimensional lattice. These four types of symmetries are found in any lattice. Together, they can form many possible combinations. Since inversion is applicable only in three-dimensional lattice, the combinations formed from rotation and reflection symmetry in two-dimensional lattice is called point group, which is 10. But the number of combinations made by rotation, reflection, and inversion in three-dimension is 32. If we add translational symmetry to these combinations, it is called a space group. That is to say, the combinations made from all four symmetries are called space group, which is 17 in two dimensions and 230 in three dimensions.